Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to split a design into a multi-hoop setup. So what we're looking at right now is just my screen in Embrilliance, and it's set up for a 4-inch by 4-inch embroidery hoop. These are the really tiny hoops that you get, not really tiny, but the kind of the standard hoops you get on the Brother PE 535 and some of those other Brother machines. Okay, well, first thing you need to know is figure out what kind of multi-hoop you have. I ordered this one off of Amazon, and this is the multi-hoop. And you can see that it has two brackets right there. And that's, whoops, it's probably easier to see if I just, there we go. It has two brackets at the bottom. So you clip it in one location, do your stitching, and then you clip it in another location and do the stitching. It gives you a lot more area. So it's about 7 inches by 4 inches as opposed to 4 inches by 4 inches. And as you can see, the price is super cheap. So it was great just to even try it out, even though I have bigger embroidery machines. I will link to that product below in the description. All right, so how do you set up Embrilliance to be able to work with this? This is a 4-inch by 4-inch hoop. I need to change it to that specific hoop. So I am going to go to Embrilliance and then Preferences, and then I'll switch this little button to Multi-Hoop. And this particular hoop is 100 by 172. Now this is in millimeters, but down here it says it's approximately 4 inches by 7 inches. And I could look up those exact dimensions on the description, but I can tell you right now I know that's right because the one dimension stays about the same, which is 4 inches, and one grows to about 7 inches. So that's the one I want for my particular situation. So I'm going to hit apply and then okay. Now, I should have shown you first the design that I was going to stitch out. I have it right here. And you can see this would not have fit within 4 by 4 inches, which is why I need that multi-hoop. Now, just saving it right now as a .pes file and bringing it over to your embroidery machine using this multi-hoop is not going to work. What we need to do is we need to run a utility that's only available in Embrilliance Enthusiast. So I'm going to go to Utility, and I have that utility. It's called Split Into Hoop. And I'm going to select it. Look over to the right before I select it. Let me move my mouse over there, where it says Cricut Large. You can see that there's just three different color stops. Let's see what happens when I do this Split Into Hoop. Now you can see that it's broken it up into two different projects, not projects, two different groups over here. The first group is the top, and it always puts in this basting box. You could delete it if you didn't want to, but what that does is as soon as you clip the hoop on and you load the design in, it stitches this out as a basting box and just kind of holds it in place. And obviously you're going to rip that out when you're done. Now it's going to do the green in the top hoop when you have it clipped into position right here. And then it's going to do the black elements, and those are the black elements that are inside of that first hooping area. And then finally the little eyeballs. Now if we go down here, then we move the hoop into place, we're going to do the basting box again. Again, that's optional. You could skip that if you wanted to or delete it. And then it's going to do the green area. And then it will do the black. So in this case, this is a pretty simple design, so you're not going to get any weird overlapping. In some cases, you may want to clip it into the first position, do all of the green, then move it to the next position, do all of the green, and make that continuous. Then go back and do some of the black. This is just in case there's kind of, if you did it in the order that Embrilliance suggested, you'd end up with elements under other elements that you didn't want. So just be mindful of that. It's always a good idea to preview the stitch out and see how that's going to work out. But in this case, I think it'll look pretty seamless. Now you don't have to break your designs exactly where Embrilliance tells you to either. So before we did, let's go back to create, or back out of Stitch Ed Simulator. Let's go back. I'm going to say undo, And I will open my Cricut again. I could do something like this. I'm gonna select all and just move it up. Now this is a bad example because it doesn't really work, but imagine that all of the green fit into one of the hoop areas. I'm just going to, well, what would be a good idea is if I had, let's just imagine it's a little bit smaller. Okay, but it still is not gonna, so let's say it was like that. It's again, not a great idea to distort my design and to size it down when it's given to me as a PES file, but this is for demonstration purposes only. If I use the utility and split into hoop, now because I've positioned all of that green area, well, it moved it down. Well, actually, no. Because I've moved all the green area into the top hoop, I don't have to do any in the bottom. So I'm not going to get a break in my green color. Now, in the bottom hooping, it's just the black of the little legs in the bottom. So anyway, that is how you work with a multi-hoop hoop and split your designs so that they'll stitch out broken in two parts or more if you have a bigger multi-hoop.